Dr. Kiran Varandan. Today, I am going to talk about a very common issue which is neglected by a large section of the people, and it indirectly affects the personality development. But with a little attention and timely intervention, we can help the younger generation become more confident and develop a very good personality in their life. We all smile every day. Have you seen some people holding back their smile because they have irregular teeth? Before going into details, let me say a few words about dentistry and orthodontics. There is a misconception about dentistry among a large group of people. They think that dentist only deals with teeth and dentistry is only about plucking teeth and filling it in case of teeth. So what is dentistry? Dentistry is a broad medical specialty that deals with teeth, gum, nerves and jaw. So for sure, it is more than teeth. Then what is this orthodontics and how is it related to dentistry? In simple words, orthodontics is something to do with the cosmetic part of dentistry. It is something more to do with your personality, smile, confidence, etc. So it is a very interesting and important subject for all of us. Everybody knows how important your smile is. It is the very first thing that people notice about you. There are many people who want to smile, but they hold back their smile because they do not want to show their crowded or crooked teeth to the public. Why should we struggle like this when it is possible to correct your teeth and bring back your smile to your face? Let us come back to our subject, orthodontics. Technically, orthodontics is a specialty within dentistry that focuses on prevention, diagnosis, and treatment of dental and facial irregularities. The specialist in orthodontics is called an orthodontist. Crowding, gap in between two front teeth, more spacing between teeth, protrusion of teeth and jaw, rotated teeth, etc. are some of the common irregularities which can be treated by orthodontist. Actually, many people are ignoring the symptoms of irregularities. If you discover it early and start treatment early, it will be easy, less costly and less inconvenient too. Before going into the best time to approach an orthodontist, let us see how these irregularities are developing and how you can detect or discover it. Orthodontic problems may be present in children at birth due to genetics or may develop during the early childhood due to early or late loss of baby teeth and habits like thumb sucking. So, the best time to approach an orthodontist is during the early childhood, that is by 7 years of age. If you see any kind of irregularities developing in your child's mouth, like crowded or crooked teeth, difficulty to pronounce certain words, mouth breathing, etc. Most kids usually stop sucking their thumb around the age of 2 to 4. If they are still doing it when permanent teeth begin to emerge, typically around the age of 6, then it requires attention. Another issue is the early or late loss of baby teeth. Your child typically starts losing teeth around the age of 6 or 7 years and the process continues till the age of 12 years. If the child is losing primary teeth much earlier or later than usual, then it's a sign of developing orthodontic problem. If your child's jaw shifts when eating or is visibly out of alignment, the problem can worsen without orthodontic treatment. In addition to various other issues, orthodontic problems in youngsters can impair the speech and affect their facial appearance. This can have a very significant impact on their self-esteem and affect their social interaction as well as school performance. Research have shown that treatment to correct crooked teeth results in considerable improvement in self-regard and quality of life. There are many oral appliances, fixed as well as removable, that can be used to move the youngster's teeth, influence jaw growth and retrain the muscles. These devices apply gentle pressure on the jaw and teeth. The most common fixed appliance is braces. It consists of wires, bands and brackets. Thanks to technology, braces today are less obtrusive and more comfortable. Another popular alternative to traditional braces among teens is clear aligners, which are practically invisible. Space maintainer is another type of appliance used as a preventive measure in children to prevent future orthodontic problems. These appliances can be removable or fixed and enables the adult teeth to grow into place by keeping space available for them. And then there is the palatal expander, which are devices that widen the arch of the upper jaw. These are only some of the wide variety of options available in orthodontics to treat a child with irregularities. If signs of irregularities do not show up in the mixed dentition stage, that is, when both milk teeth and permanent teeth are present, then orthodontic treatment is carried out after all the permanent teeth have erupted. That is, between the age of 11.5 to 14 years for girls and 12 to 15 years for boys. Having had a preliminary orthodontic assessment by the age of 7 years to screen for any irregularities help assure you that the treatment will be easier when carried out at this age. Orthodontic treatments are not only limited to young patients, corrections can also be done at the adult stage even after the completion of growth. In such cases, surgery is combined with orthodontics and it is called surgical orthodontics. Surgical orthodontics, also called orthognathic surgery, is corrective jaw surgery performed to remedy skeletal problems that affect the ability to bite, chew, and speak. Orthodontic treatment is done before and after surgery so that the upper and lower teeth meet appropriately and the individual is able to bite, chew, and speak more effectively. Unlike children, adults are no longer growing, so the only way to modify the size and shape of the jawbones of adults is only through surgery. Surgical orthodontics is recommended for adults who have a severe problem with the positions of their teeth and jaws, which cannot be corrected by orthodontic treatment alone. Having said all this, in short, if you see any irregularities related to your teeth, jaws, speech, etc., please visit an orthodontist or any other dental practitioner who can guide you in the right direction. As the old saying says, prevention is better than cure. Yes, we should try preventing known issues. But there is also another saying, never too late. So, for some reason, if you are not able to prevent it, then remember that it is not too late.